Birds are masters of maneuverability in ways that we are only beginning to understand.
Birds can dramatically change the shape of their wing almost instantly and respond in that way very quickly to flying in turbulence, avoiding obstacles, and also flying very effectively over long distances. Here we are in front of a brand new bird wind tunnel. It's a wind tunnel in which we can study how birds fly up close so that we can learn the magic of flight and translate that into better flying robots. What's great about it is that we can vary the speed of the wind very precisely, from very close to 0 meters per second all the way to about 50 meters per second, which is very fast.
The tunnel is designed to be super low turbulence, but we also want to study how birds fly in turbulence and how we design vehicles that are more stable in turbulence. So we also have this turbulence generation system. We can actually not only control how strong the turbulence is, but where the turbulence is in the tunnel.
Birds are flying at 10 meters per second, but in our lab, they're basically not moving. Because it's still in the same little test section, we could use a lot of our other lab equipment, like our high-speed cameras and our motion tracking devices, to measure all the kinematics and forces that it's generating without needing to use up a large expansive space that would be necessary without the wind tunnel.
I've been working with both lovebirds and parrotlets. The technique we use is all positive reinforcement for voluntary flights. And that way we're getting calm, natural flights as they would be in their natural environment.
Students are super excited to figure out what is it that enables birds to fly under these complex conditions, and how can we translate what we find into developing robots that can be used for delivery, search and rescue, any application in an urban environment where conditions like wind are really unpredictable.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.